In today's khutbah, I would like to begin with talking about this incident which took place in New York. And this is where we come to this issue, unfortunately, again and again, that those who go around killing innocent people, like this fellow who drove his truck onto the path of the cyclist and killed 8 people and injured many others, they're really not followers of any religion. They are simply terrorists, nothing more, nothing less than that. You know, it's interesting we refer to this issue of the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia last Friday's khutbah, where he's talking, bringing Saudi Arabia to the moderate version of Islam. You know, I hope if he has any conscience, looks at these reports and see the impact of extremism that his country has spun around the world. And this is going on. It's out of their control also. And these extremists who call themselves Muslims, they have to go back to the basics. If they are in any way misguided or they think this is Islam, they need to go back to the Quran. In Surah Maida, chapter 5 of the Quran, ayat number 32, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a very clear statement, doesn't need any tafsir or anything, referring to this rule of retaliation which is there in the Old Testament, in Torah, that, you know, a life for a life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about it, وَمِنْ أَجْلِ ذَٰلِكَ كَتَبْنَا عَلَى بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ أَنَّهُ مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْعَرْضِ كَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسِ جَمِيعًا. A person who kills an innocent human being without any, you know, blame or fault of that victim, he is as if he has killed the entire humanity. And the reverse of that is وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. And if you rescue one life, it is as if you have rescued the entire humanity. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَتْهُمْ رُسُلُنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we sent our rusul, our messengers, with clear guidelines. These issues are very simple, very clear. And this is where, you know, we come to realize that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if one innocent person is killed, as if that person has killed everyone, you know, sometimes people say, how can it be? He just killed one person. You know, those who are very much into numbers. One is only one. Can't be the whole humanity. Well, this is the issue, that if one innocent life is lost, then there is no guarantee for the safety of the others. The sanctity of human life is basically shattered by killing one innocent soul. And this is where we see on the other side, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, you know, this human soul, human life is so sacred that if you save one, it is as if you have saved everyone on the level of, you know, worth of that good deed. When you look at this tafsir, you know, there are different levels of, you know, explaining this ayat. At different levels, as Amir al-Mu'mineen has a very famous statement, where he says that the ayat of Quran has 7 layers of its apparent meaning and 7 levels of its deeper meaning. So yes, you don't discount the zahiri meaning. It is there, applicable, enforceable. Everybody has to follow and believe in it. But there are also different levels of understanding the ayat of Quran. For example, we see in the ahadith under this ayat, where the ayah says, whoever kills one innocent soul is killed everyone, or one who rescues one life has rescued everyone. If you start a tradition which is positive and good in our faith and our, for benefit of our community, and other follows it, other people follow it, then actually you get the reward for as long as that good deed that you initiated, you know, continues for a generation and generation and generations after that. You know, this concept of sadaqah jariyah that we talk about, you know, you only did it once. Others followed your example. By following your example, you get part of the share of the good deeds that they are doing. And others will look at them, and you know, they also replicate that activity. On the other side, we have to be careful. If we start as, you know, bid'atun sayya, and others start following it, then remember, it's not only I who have done it, all those who followed that, I will have a share in the adab of those good deeds, bad deeds that they have done till the end. If you rescue and take one human being out of the state of poverty, he is no more dependent, he is self-reliant now. You have rescued him and his dependents. This is also, we are told, it's just like you have saved the entire humanity. Just by rescuing one person, taking him out of the state of poverty. And the most important level that we see in the hadith is that if you are able to guide one individual to the right path, he was confused, he was misguided, he was on another path, and you were able to guide that person. Guiding one person to the right path is as if you have guided everyone on the level of ajr and sawab is concerned. And of course, on the flip side, if you do something where you end up misguiding someone, you know, the wabal and the azab and the consequences of that also falls on you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the insight to understand the wisdom of the Quran and always to do whatever is according to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In أحسن الحديث كتاب الله العزيز بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحليم الكريم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب وهو الغفور الرحيم ونشهد أن لا إله إلا هو العطوف على العباد بجوده والعواد على المذنبين بحلمه ونشهد أن محمدا نبيه وحبيبه سيد المرسلين وشفيع المذنبين ورحمة للعالمين صلى الله عليه وآله الداعين إلى سبيل الله بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة قادة الأمم وأولياء النعمة ومعدن الرحمة أوصيكم عباد الله بالتوبة ما سلف من ذنوبكم. We are into the 10 days ending to 40 of Sayyid al-Shuhada. Millions of Zairin and pilgrims are on their way to Karbala. Some of them are flying towards there. Some of them are driving. And many, many more will be actually walking from different parts of Iraq towards the city of Karbala. This is their way of expressing their devotion to Imam Hussain alayhi salam, and a visible way of popularizing the message of Hussain ibn Ali. It is actually a communal way of expressing the feeling that we would like people to remember the suffering of the women and the children of Hussein. And this basically forces the world to pay attention to it. If you see the numbers of people who go there, this becomes, in a way, world news. You know, the world pays attention. And this is where it leads to this question, who is Hussein? Yeah, there is now an organization known as Who is Hussein? But all these activities which are done on a communal level, that is the purpose. To make people think about it and ask the question, who is Hussein? Was he killed recently? No, 1400 years ago. why people still remember him as if he is killed now. And this is where, when we talk about what is known as mazahir of azadari, manifestation of azadari, as long as all these manifestations are within the bounds of the Sharia, this actually become a very powerful way of bringing the name of Hussein ibn Ali to the world. If you look at the verse from Surah Ma'idah that I recited in the earlier khutbah there, where the ayah says, killing one innocent person is like killing the entire humanity. Anyone, it could be anyone, but the ayah says, من قتل نفسا بغير نفس أو فسادا في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا. It could be anyone. But what if that soul and that life is of somebody who is the best of the Ibadullah at that time? There was no one more ashraf, more noble than Hussein bin Ali. He was not only the grandson of the Prophet and son of Ali and Fatima. He was there not just as an individual. You know these words that we have from our sixth Imam in Ziyarat Waris, that in Karbala, Hussein was not just one person. He was Waris of Adam, heir of Adam, of Nuh, of Ibrahim, of Musa, of Isa. Means he basically came with the legacy of the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which started from Adam, ended with Rasulullah. He carries that legacy. And so when you have somebody on that level, and if you take, you kill that person, what would be the level of the adab? Because the ayah says any innocent person. We are not talking about just any person here. We are talking about somebody who was the best of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that time. And this is where we had to realize that it was not only Hussein bin Ali. They were actually targeting Islam itself. They were planning actually to kill Islam itself. But Hussein didn't allow that. He said, you want me, you take my head, but I'll not give you my hand. And so they took his head, but he did not give his hand into the hand of Yazid. And this is where we come to realize that, you know, when the Prophet said, Husaynun minni wa ana min Husayn, that I'm from Hussein, this is what he means. That Islam would have died, but it was the sacrifice of Hussein ibn Ali which has kept it alive. You know, when Imam Hussain alayhi salam left Medina, after the initial encounter between Walid, the governor of Yazid in Medina, and Marwan, there's another conversation, very simple, on the streets before Imam leaves Medina. And Marwan tries to advise him that it is good for your dunya and akhirah to pledge allegiance to Yazid. What does Imam say? He says, you know, the day بُلِيَتْ الْأُمَّةِ بِرَاعٍ مِثْلَ يَزِيد, the day the Ummah accepts a person like Yazid as a legitimate ruler, فَعَلَى الْإِسْلَامَ السَّلَامِ, I will say Khuda Hafiz to Islam. We cannot accept that Islam. And then he uses the words, he says, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, which we normally say to a person who has died, that if the Ummah considers Yazid to be the legitimate ruler, it's as if Islam has died. And I'll not allow that to happen. And this is where we are to realize the importance of Hussein ibn Ali and the way we are remembering him. And it is actually, you know, because of Hussein that the pure Islam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has survived. One way you should look at the azaf Sayyid al-Shuhada is to thank him for whatever good that you see about Islam. This has been preserved because of his sacrifice. Otherwise, it would have been something completely different. And this is where we come back to the statement of one of the scholars who say, Al-Islam Muhammadiyul Wujud wa Husayniyul Baqa. Islam started, came to exist because of Muhammad, but it survived because of Hussein bin Ali alayhi salatu wasalam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all the azadar of Hussein wherever they are, especially those who travel to Iraq, to Karbala for the Arbaeen. May he keep them in his protection and guidance, inshallah. Allahumma salli ala sayyidil mursaleen wa shafi'il mudhunibin nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. وعلى إمام المتقين وعمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب صلوات الله عليه وعلى سيدة نساء العالمين سيدتنا فاطمة بنت رسول الله صلوات الله عليها وعلى سيد الشباب أهل الجنة الحسن المجتبى والحسين الشهيد بكربلاء عليهم الصلاة والسلام. اللهم صل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي عليهم الصلاة والسلام. اللهم صل على مولانا الحجة بن الحسن صاحب العصر والزمان. ما أحيى آثار البدو والطغيان هادم أمنية الشرك والنفاق حاسد فرو البغي والشقاق صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آبائه الكرام ما اتصلت الليالي والأيام. اللهم عجل فرج وصح المخرج واكحل ناظرنا بنظرة منا إليه واجعلنا من المستشهدين بين يديه. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى. إن الله يعمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.